Dexteram Testing, Alpha Testing Procedures for Shroud of the Avatar, Home by Home Walkthrough. These lots contain purchasable houses for players, eventually. For the purposes of alpha testing, we were given access to all of them, so I systematically, one by one, went by and did a walk around and walkthrough of each. The procedure is pretty similar for every home I do. I will talk you through this one and then only point out issues for each subsequent home or building. Here I walk around to try to get a nice angle up at as much as the house as possible. The camera is limited in alpha. I find nothing of note, I believe. Or do I? Here I find something. This little nook right here, you can clearly see through a polygon, which you probably shouldn't be able to. Back and forth, double checking. Yes, I think that's wrong. Let me go back over here and see if it happens again. And it does. Hardly significant, but noticeable. So I noted it. Once I'm done with the walk around, I enter the facility. Take a look around. Let me close these doors. Make it a little bit easier for me. I don't always close the doors, but sometimes I do. These window objects, will routinely have seams around them or cracks in the polygons where the bricks meet up with them. You'll see that throughout. Sometimes the aesthetics of the brick, for example, that crown molding, we'll call it down at the bottom, will be irregular. I don't know if I spot any of that on this example or not. Checking for those cracks up in the wall. Checking the windows. Go upstairs and check that out. Now, throughout these videos, you'll see me running up and down the stairs frequently because I would routinely fall through stairs, and I wanted to see if it was something that was atypical, and it seemed to be. Here's just, you know, camera through the wall, that happens, but I slowed down to show it. That's what you get when your polygon's only two-dimensional, as it were. Do-do-do. Over here, I think I saw something in that window. Yep. Here's what I'm talking about, objects not being flushed into the building. Some are more dramatic than others. I'll point them all out. Okay, moving on. Checking my corners, my seams, my ceiling. I say my, but I mean this building. From my perspective, go up to the third floor. Did I check this side? Quick double check in case I didn't. Everything looks good, I guess. I know I checked this side, but here I come again because at the time I didn't remember doing it. Nice view up top here. Oh, I just saw something on the bottom of that floor I didn't see at the time. Coming up that stair, you might note it. Then I go and check all four of these. I think at one point I tried to slip off the top of the building. Yeah, here I do. I creep up just a little. So I'm on the same plane as the exterior wall. But good doobie, they put an invisible barrier there. Good job. Check out this one. Nice view of the place. Whoa! No invisible barrier there. I'm down to the floor. On on a revisit of this potentially in the future, I would probably follow the same procedure, check the same floorings, etc. Then I just come out, cycle through to the next house. Repeat. Walk around. Exterior. Check the gaps. Go inside and check it. I think rather than doing voiceover, I will try to do overlays, so there will be points of emphasis. Here's a crack in the door. Most of the doors are like this. It's perhaps insignificant again. It's just one of those things that I noted. In case somebody who's a perfectionist might want to address it, or it might not be something that can be addressed. In any event, I'll let this run out. This video report is approximately 24 minutes long and culminates in an event where I find a significant error that would cause a permanent stuck situation for a player avatar, wherein they'd have to recycle the initiation sequence, aka log out and log back in. You'll see it when you get to it. Enjoy me bumping around walls trying to break everything.